So why did the flooding hit Ames so hard? This map helps to answer that question. Squaw Creek literally divides the city in two, as we've told you. When it floods, it cuts the east half of Ames off from the west side. Earlier, Angie Hunt brought us live reports from Ames on the flooding problems there.
And now Steve Karlin shows us that flooding from an elevated perspective. Steve.
That's right, Stacey. Flood water always looks bad enough on the ground, but as News Channel 8 photojournalist Glenn Bierman and I found out today, high over Ames, it can look even worse from the air.
We begin north of Ames near the Ada Hayden Reservoir, following the Skunk River south into the city. The Skunk and Squaw Creek are running unabated. Way out of their banks, their boundaries unclear. First stop, Iowa Highway 6569 and Riverside Road, where water from the Skunk is sloshing into several area businesses. Up next, South River Valley Park on East 13th Street. No softball or any other sports here for quite a while. Now over to Stang Road and Vanker Memorial Golf Course. What a water hazard. Vanker is a greenskeeper's nightmare. Here's a look at Brookside Park on 6th Street. It's now just an oversized brook. And take a peek at the 6th Street Railroad Underpass. It's a wide open floodgate funneling filthy water into the east side of the Iowa State University campus, which is kaput. All kinds of college buildings look like they were constructed on a lake. Workers sandbagged and built barricades, but to no avail. Hilton Coliseum is now a water hole. The rest of the Iowa State Center buildings either have water running through them or are seriously threatened. That huge parking lot between Hilton and Jack Trice Stadium is littered with lots of floating porta-potties. Off in southeast Ames, Duff Avenue is deluged. Waist-deep water has invaded Walmart and overtaken Target. Lots of closed signs in this business-heavy part of town look to be up for quite a while. Then there's U.S. Highway 30. It's almost completely covered between Duff Avenue and Dayton Road. But the real traffic snarl can be found just south of Highway 30 on Interstate 35. It is shut down.
Now, lots of people say they haven't seen flooding like this since 1993. A lot of us around here saw that too, and I have to agree with that. Unfortunately, right now, there is water as far as the eye can see up in Ames. Stacy.
Those pictures are just amazing. Thank you, Steve.